In this video, we're going to look at how to create and edit posts on your website. Once you've logged into WordPress, in the left-hand menu, expand your post section. And first of all, you can have a look at all the posts you currently have on your website by clicking All Posts. To create a new post, you can either click Add New in this section, or you can click Add New in the left-hand menu. This will give you a blank form to complete to create your new post. So all you need to do is add your post title in this title section. This next section here is where you can add the text and images for your website. This section here, the corner, bottom right hand corner, you can click on and expand, just drag it down to expand the view to give you a bit more space. You have a visual tab which will show you exactly what the text will look like. And if you need to paste any HTML code on your post, just click the HTML tab to give you that view. We're going to go back to visual. You'll also see here many options to edit and style your page. First of these are these four icons here. The first icon allows you to add an image to your post. The second icon gives you the option to add a video. The third, to add an audio, and the fourth, to add any other media. This section here is, if you like, your WYSIWYG, or what you see is what you get, editor. You can bold text, italicize, you can create lists, numbered lists. You can align your text to the left, centered, or to the right. You can add links or remove links, and many other different options as well. This button here is called the Show or Hide Kitchen Sink, and if you click on this, you can remove your options, and if you click on it again, you can show all your editing options. This next row here gives you options to change the style of your text from a heading to paragraph or other styles. You can underline your text. You can justify it. This gives you the option to change the color of your text. You can also erase the formatting. You can insert other characters, and you could indent your text as well. These two options here allow you to undo what you've just done or redo what you've just done. And also the help button should you have any other questions. Now, so what we'll do here is we're going to add some text to our post. And we've added the text in, so let's add a heading here. Call that heading 1. And to change it to a larger font, we're going to highlight that text and come up to the drop-down menu here for your text styles, and we're going to choose Heading 1. Now we might add another heading just here, so this will be Heading 2. And again, we can highlight that. Maybe change that to Heading 2. Now what we'd also like to do is add an image. So I'm going to place my cursor where I'd like my image to be. And I'm going to come up here and click on Add an Image. Now you have three different options. You can add media files from your computer. So you can select files from somewhere on your computer. If you click Open, that will upload that image to your post. You can use an image from another URL. In fact, you could use an image from any other website. You would just place that URL in this section here and then click Insert into Post. What we're going to do here is add an image from our media library. And we've already added an image to our library, which is this one here. So all we need to do is click Show, and that gives us the information, just to be sure that's the one we want, and yes, that is. I'm going to come down to Alignment, and I'm going to leave the alignment as left, and leave the size of the image at full size. And then just click Insert into Post. And there we have it. We've got an image. Now we can see that the text is butting up against this image, and I'd like there to be a little bit more space. So to change that, we need to click on the image, and this first little icon here is called Edit Image. So we're going to click on that. And this brings up an editing box. To create that space next to the photo, we're going to click on Advanced Settings, and down here we're going to make vertical space about 10 and horizontal space about 10, and you can see that gives us a nice border or space around our image. We're going to click Update, and there you are, we've got a nice space around our image. And that looks pretty good. That's the way I'd like it to be. So then we need to fill in the rest of the options. If you have any plugins, for example, any SEO plugins, you'll find some options underneath your main editing area. And just go through and change any of those options that you'd like. And then we need to scroll back up the top of the post. And in the right-hand column, we need to choose this second section called Categories. We need to choose where we want our post to appear on our website. And I think I will call this Featured. So I'm going to tick Featured, and now that post will appear in the Featured Categories. The next section we have is Post Tags. Tags are a way to mark what your post is about, and other websites such as bookmarking websites and blog websites will use this information to categorize your posts into the right relevant tags. So we can see here, we can either choose the most used tags that we've already created on our site. So if we click that, it'll bring up a list of all the tags that we're currently using. If none of those suit, we can create a new tag. Or we'll call that New Ideas. And then click Add. And we have a new tag created. And once you're happy with that, you need to either save a draft of your website. If you're not quite ready to publish it, that will save a copy in your list, and you can go back to it and change it and edit it until you're ready to publish. Once you are ready to publish, you can click the Publish button here, and that makes your post live and available to the world. And if we click on View Post, there we have it. There is your post, published and ready, available on your website. So if we go back to our posts, if we click on All Posts, we can see the latest one we've done is just at the top of the list. Now, should you want to edit that post once it's published, all you need to do is, if you hover over the title of the post, you'll see there's some options. You can throw the post post to trash should you want to start again or get rid of it completely. You can also edit, so click on edit and that will take you to the post where you can make any changes you like. Just remember to click on update once you're done for those new changes to take. And there you are. You've created a new post and edited a post.